English class. Hope you all are safe and healthy at home. Today we gonna discuss yet another interesting lesson from Whispers on the Face of It, written by Susan Hill. Are you all ready to listen to the new lesson? If you are ready, let's begin. On the Face of It means there is so much of diversity, so many differences and divides between the people and other species of the world. But underneath is a oneness, a sameness. All of them are created by God and all of them need to live and grow together with love and mutual acceptance. As the play progresses, the characters' views about each other and our impression of them changes for the better. Thus, Susan Hill has quite appropriately entitled her play On the Face of It. Let's hear about the author, Susan Hill. She is an English author of fiction and non-fiction works. Her novels include The Woman in Black, The Mist in the Mirror, and I'm the King of the Castle, for which she received the Somerset Maugham Award in 1971. On the Face of It is a play featuring an old man and a small boy meeting in the farmer's garden. The old man strikes up a friendship with the boy, who is very withdrawn and defiant. What is the bond that unites the two? On the Face of It is a play featuring about an old man and a boy meeting in the old man's garden. That's the play. After that, the old man strikes a friendship with this boy. Actually, the boy here is very withdrawn and defiant. What is the meaning of defiant? Yes, you know that he rebels, okay, always. Whatever people used to say, he just opposes everything, okay? He's a rebel type of person, very rough, okay? So, the old man is entirely different from him. But there was a bond between them and the old man strikes a friendship with the boy. What was the bond between them? How they become friends? That we gonna discuss through this play On the Face of It, written by Susan Hill. Scene 1. Mr. Lamb's garden. There is the occasional sound of bird song and of tree leaves rustling. Derry's footsteps are heard as he walks slowly and tentatively through the long grass he possesses, then walks on again. He comes round a screen of bushes so that when Mr. Lamb speaks to him, he is so close at hand and Derry is startled. Mr. Lamb, mind the apples. Derry, what? Who's that? Who's there? Mr. Lamb, Lamb's my name. Mind the apples. Crab apples those are. When falls in the long grass, you could trip. Derry, I thought this was an empty place. I didn't know there was anybody here. Mr. Lamb, that's all right. I'm here. What are you afraid of, boy? That's all right. Derry, I thought it was empty, an empty house. Mr. Lamb, so it is. Since I'm out here in the garden, it's empty. Until I go back inside, in the meantime, I'm out here and likely to stop a day like this. Beautiful day, not a day to be indoors. Derry, panic, I have got to go. Mr. Lamb, not on my account. I don't mind who comes into the garden. The gate's always open. Only you climb the garden wall. Derry, angry, you were watching me. Mr. Lamb, I saw you, but the gate's open. All welcome. You are welcome. I sit here. I like sitting. Derry, I not come to steal anything. Mr. Lamb, no, the young lad steals from the apples. You are not so young. Derry, I just wanted to come in into the garden. Mr. Lamb, so you did. Here we are then. Derry, you don't know who I am. Mr. Lamb, a boy, 13 or so. Derry, 14. Boss, but I have got to go now. Goodbye. Mr. Lamb, nothing to be afraid of. Just a garden, just me. Derry, but I'm not. I'm not afraid, boss. People are afraid of me. Mr. Lamb, why should that be? Derry, everyone is. It doesn't matter who they are or what they see or how they look, how they pretend. I know, I can see. Mr. Lamb, see what? Derry, what do they think? Mr. Lamb, what do they think then? Daddy, you think here is a boy, you look at me and then you see my face and you think that's bad, that's a terrible thing, that's the ugliest thing I ever saw. You think, poor boy, but I'm not poor. Underneath, you are afraid. Anybody would be. When I look in the mirror and see it, I'm afraid of me. Scene 1. I told you this is a play, okay? So scene 1, you just imagine a garden, okay? So occasional sounds you can hear now. What is the occasional sounds in the garden? Yes, of course, birds chirping and rustling of leaves and the other things you can hear in the garden, okay? Here, now our main character, the central character enters, okay? His name is Derry, okay? He's a boy. And he climbed the garden wall. A long wall is there in the garden. So he climbed the garden wall and got into the garden, okay? And slowly he starts moving forward. Okay, clear? Listen carefully. The boy, he is the central character of our lesson. His name is Derry. He climbed the long wall of the garden and he got inside the garden and slowly he starts walking. Immediately, he just heard a voice near him, okay? Mind the apples. Those are crab apples. So, actually this boy thought that nobody's there inside the garden, okay? That's why he was just going inside, okay? Immediately, he heard the sound of an old man, okay? That old man says, mind the apples. Those are crab apples. What's the meaning of crab apple? Yes, crab apple means wild apples, okay? So the man says, mind the wild apples, okay? Yesterday, there was heavy wind and all the apples, most of the apples, it had fallen down. Now, it's just on the grass. You could see the crab apples. So, if you just step on it, you may fall. That's why you please mind the apples while walking. Be careful. Otherwise, you would be tripped, like the old man says. So the old man's name is Mr. Lamb. Okay, only you could see these two characters in this play. Derry and Mr. Lamb. So, when the old man says like this, immediately Derry replied, oh sorry, I thought that nobody is here. It's empty. The garden and inside the garden a house is also there. So I thought that the house and the garden is empty. Nobody is here. Like that I thought. That's why I just came in. Like Derry says. Okay, now I have to go. Because I just met you here. I don't want to be here. I just want to go out. Like he says. So the old man said that. Anyhow, you have come. You wish to come here. You come here. Not on my account. You must go out. Okay, it's not like that. If you want to sit here, you can. Okay, sit and enjoy. I am the owner of this garden. I never mind people coming inside and go. That's why I always keep the gates open. Now also the gate is open. You did not see the gate and you only climbed the wall and came here like this. Okay, he says. That time, Derry got angry. He said that when I climbed the wall and jumped inside, you were watching me and you didn't ask me anything. You didn't tell me anything why I was doing such thing. Okay? And you were just simply watching me, like he asked. So, the old man says that you did so. I cannot say anything. Gate is always open and whoever wants to come in can come. You climbed the wall and came. I was just simply sitting. That is my routine. Every time I used to come out of the house and sit here because I like sitting and enjoying my garden, okay? That's why today also I have come here. That time you just climbed the wall and got inside, okay? You only did. I cannot say anything. Anyhow, if you want to enjoy the garden, for that if you come, you can. Like he says, okay, who says? The old man, Mr. Lamb. Then Derry says that I have come here not to steal anything like that, he says, okay. Because Derry thought that nobody's there in the garden. He just simply wants to sit some time like that. He just came. But when he just met the old man, he just immediately says that I have come here not to steal anything. You don't think like that, he corrected, okay. So the old man says that, yes, many kids used to come to my garden. They just steal something. Many fruits are here, even the crab apples also. They just come and spoil everything. like, okay, those are kids only, but you are not so small, okay? I think you are 13 years old boy. So like the old man, Mr. Lamb, says, that time Devi corrected again, I'm not 13 years old boy, I'm 14 years old, like he says. And now again Devi says that, okay, now you are here, I thought this garden and the house is empty, that's why only I have come. Now immediately I want to go back, I don't want to spend time here, like he says. So Mr. Lamb says that, boy, see, if you want to come and enjoy here, you can do, okay? I won't say anything because I just allow people to come inside and enjoy my garden. I don't have any problem at all. Why are you just going out? Are you scared of me? Okay, are you afraid of me? Like he asked the old man. So Devi said that, I'm not afraid of anyone. At the same time, people are afraid of me. Listen carefully. The old man asked that, are you afraid of me? Okay. So Devi, the boy, 14 years old boy, replied that, I'm not afraid of anyone. Actually, people are afraid of me, like he says. So the old man just, he asked that, why people are afraid of you? What's the problem? So the boy started speaking. He says that, whenever, if you also, not only people, if you also see my face, you may think that poor, very ugly face, like that many thoughts will come and you sometimes you will be pity on me. But I don't like such talks or such thinking, understood? I don't like. And I know that whoever see my face, they are afraid of me. Even when I look at the mirror, I'm afraid of me, like that the boy says. Okay, not only people, when I look at the mirror myself, that time I'm afraid of me, like the boy says to the old man, Mr. Lamb. Okay, so the boy's name is Derry, he's a 14 years old boy, and the old man, he is Mr. Lamb. Okay, where they meet, where did they met? Yes, they just met in the garden, Mr. Lamb's garden. Okay, and this is the first scene. Let's just go forth. Mr. Lamb, no, not the whole of you, not of you, Derry. Yes, pause. Mr. Lamb, later on, when it's a bit cooler, I'll get the ladder and a stick and pull down those crab apples. They are ripe for it. I mean, Delhi, it's a good time of year, September. Look at them. Orange and golden, that's magic fruit. I often see, but it's best picked and made into jelly. You could give me a hand. Delhi, what have you changed the subject for? People always do that. Why don't you ask me? Why do you do what they all do and pretend it is not true and it's not there? In case I see you looking and mind and get upset, I'll tell you, you don't ask me because you are afraid too. Mr. Lamb, you want me to ask? Say so then. Daddy, I don't like being with people, any people. Mr. Lamb, I should say, to look at it, I should say, you got burned in a fire. Derry, not in a fire. I got acid all down that side of my face and it burned it all away. It ate my face up. It ate me up. And now it's like this and it won't ever be any different. So the boy says that when I just look at the mirror, I'm afraid of me. Like he says, okay. So Mr. Lamb said that, not whole. Means that, when I just look at you, I'm not afraid of you, like that way he just speaks. And immediately, Mr. Lamb, the old man, changed the subject, okay? Means that he just says, Derry, that he did not want to continue that talk. So he just says, change the subject. And then he says that, okay, boy, after some time, later on, I just bring a ladder. Okay, what is that ladder? As we use the thing to climb up. So after some time, I'll bring a ladder and then you must help me to climb the tree. Okay, because see, everywhere you can see the ripe apple. Okay, that is golden and orange color, means that it's ripe. Okay. And this is the very good month, September, okay? That's September, on the month of September, it's very good to make jelly, means very good season to make jelly, because I get a lot of ripe apple, okay, crab apples. So I just make jelly this time, okay, in the month of September. Now I just want to pluck apples from the tree, so you must help me. Later on I'll bring a ladder and you give me a hand, I can climb and pluck those apples, like he just changed the subject. But Delhi, he got that this old man deliberately changed the subject. So Delhi says that, okay, old man, you are also like other people. You don't want to hear about my story and you are afraid of me. And what happened to me, you don't want to know exactly. That's why you have changed that subject, okay? Don't you want to listen to my story? Why are you just changing subject, okay? Like, he asked the question to Mr. Lamb, okay? So Mr. Lamb says that, I didn't change the subject. Actually, I need your help to pluck the apple. That only I asked. If you ask me to listen to your story, I'm ready. You can say what happened to you and all, like Mr. Lamb says. And before giving the answer, Delhi wants to say something. Before that, the old man says that, when you just came inside that moment onward, you were just talking about your face. Okay, people are afraid of you and your face and all, you were talking. So from that, I came to the conclusion, you got a fire accident and fire burned your face. Am I right? Like the old man asked. Actually, Mr. Lamb, the old man, is a very experienced person. And when we just go forth through this play, you will come to know the beautiful character, the positivity of Mr. Lamb. Okay? So just listen. He just says that you got fire accident and the fire burned your face. That's why you just say before, people are afraid of you and even you are also afraid. Okay, am I right? Like he asked. So Delhi corrected him. Not fire accident, acid. Okay, acid fell on my face and it ate up my face, like he says. So Delhi got the acid burn. Okay, acid, unfortunately, it just fell on his face and one part of the face it ate up. You know that acid falls on, what will happen? Okay, so Delhi says that, Mr. Lamb, I did not get fire accident, instead it was acid burn, okay? And one part of my face, it burned that acid, okay, with that acid, okay? And the acid just ate up my face, like he says, okay? That's why one part, you know that acid burn means the face, how it will be, okay? It looks like, that's why people are afraid of him, like he says, okay? And the boy added that, you know, see, it happened long before and when it happened that time, the acid ate up my face and still I'm like this, and in future also it will be like this. It will not go, it will not make any change. Means that acid burn means it's a permanent thing only. So I will be like this, my face will be like this, it will never changes, okay? I'll never get a recovery, so I'll be like this in the future also. Okay, this is my problem, like the boy says. Clear? Mr. Lamb, no. Delhi, aren't you interested? Mr. Lamb, you are a boy who came into the garden. Plenty do. I'm interested in anybody, anything. There's nothing God made that doesn't interest me. Look over there, over beside the far wall. What can you see? Delhi, rubbish. Mr. Lamb, rubbish? Look, boy, look. What do you see? Delhi, just grass and stuff. Weeds. Mr. Lamb, some call them weeds, if you like. Then a weed garden, that. There's fruit and there are flowers and trees and herbs, all sorts. But over there, weeds. I grow weeds there. Why is one green growing plant called a weed and another flower? What's the difference? It's all life growing, same as you and me. Delhi, we are not the same, Mr. Lamb. I'm old, you are young, you have got a burnt face, I have got a thin leg. Not important. You are standing there, I'm sitting here. What's the difference? Delhi, why have you got a thin leg? Mr. Lamb, real one got blown off years back. Lamey lamb, some kids say. Haven't you heard them? You will. Lamey lamb, it fits. Doesn't trouble me. Delhi, but you can put on trousers and cover it up and no one sees. They don't have to notice and stare. Mr. Lamb, some do, some don't. They get tired of it in the end. There's plenty of other things to share at. Delhi, like my face. Mr. Lamb, like crab apples or the words, weeds or a spider climbing up a silken ladder or my tall sunflowers. Delhi, thanks. Mr. Lamb, it's all relative, beauty and the beast. Delhi, what's that supposed to mean? Mr. Lamb, you tell me. Delhi, you needn't think they haven't all told me that fairy story before. It's not what you look like, it's what you are inside. Handsome is as handsome does. Beauty loved the monstrous beast for himself, and when she kissed him, he changed into a handsome prince. Only he wouldn't. He would have stayed a monstrous beast. I won't change. So the boy says that I won't change in future. I will be like this. Okay. So that time, Mr. Lam says no. So the boy, Derry, asks the old man that, are you not interested in my story? Like he asked. So that time, the old man, now onwards you will be getting beautiful message from this old man, okay, for our life too. So the old man asked that, boy, Derry, you just see, I just want to tell you one thing. You are just always worry about your face. You just see here in the garden. Boy, what can you see there? He asked, and he pointed far away from him. Understood? Near the wall. And then he looks there. He says that, I can see rubbish there, like he says. Okay. I told you the boy is a defiant. Okay. He is a rebel. And then he says that, I can see rubbish. Okay, and long grass, weeds, only I can see that, like the boy says. Again, the man, old man, Mr. Lamb asked that, boy, you just look there, look at that place, and then tell me, what can you see there? Again, he asked. So the boy says that, weeds, only I can see weeds there, like the boy replies. So the man says that, yes, that is your point of view. You can see a lot of things are here in the garden. You can see only the rubbish or the weeds or grass. But here, fruits, many plants are also there, and even fruits giving trees also, understood? But you don't see those things, the positive things in the garden. Only you can see. That is your point of view, understood? At the same time, Derry, you must know one thing. This is my garden, Mr. Lamb's garden. I grow weeds also here. Why you know? Because weeds also, green plants only, even fruit giving trees, weeds and everything, no difference. I don't find any difference with these plants or trees, okay? Everything else, life giving, it's growing, means that the plants, whether it is weeds or the trees, it has life, understood? I think like that. So, no difference. See, whether it is giving fruits or flowers, that tree and the weeds, I don't find any difference, okay? I just consider everything as plants only. That is my point of view, like he says, okay? Who says? Mr. Lamb. Means that whatever it is, okay, it depends on our point of view. How we look the things, that make it so. That's the message given by the old man. And again, the old man, Mr. Lamb, at that, see, and you and me are same like that. The trees, how they are same like that. People are also same. You and me, same only, no difference, like he says, okay. So Derry said that we both are not same, like he immediately corrected him, okay. That time the old man says that, yes, we are not same, means that you are young, I'm old, and you are standing, I'm sitting here, and you got a burnt face, and I got a tin leg, like he says, okay. Means that the boy says that they both are not same, like that time the old man, Mr. Lamb, says that we are also same only. You are young, I am old. You are standing, I am sitting. You got a burnt face and I got a thin leg. Only that difference I see. But basically we both are same. All people are same, like the man says. Okay. And that time only Derry came to know about his thin leg. What is the meaning of thin leg? Yes, artificial leg, means that our Mr. Lamb, he doesn't have a leg, okay? He just uses an artificial leg, okay? That is called tin leg. So, Derry asked that, how do you use the word leg? Okay, why are you using an artificial leg, like he asked. So, Mr. Lamb replies that it just had gone long ago, it's just blown off, means during a war, I just lost my leg. And you know that people, whoever comes to my garden, the kids and others used to call me as Lamy Lamb, okay? Have you heard that name? Lamy Lamb. People used to call me when they come to my garden or go outside also, whenever they just see me, used to call me as Lamy Lamb. That name fits me. Why? Because I don't have a leg, okay? I don't bother about their call, okay? If they want to call me like that, they can, okay? And and some they just used to call me like that, lamy lamb, and I don't bother about it because that name fits me. I don't have a leg. That's why people used to call me as lamy lamb. He says, okay. And after that, the old man says, see, every time people just used to say something, okay, but I don't bother about the things. If they want, they can, like the old man says. So, immediately Jerry says that, okay, you don't have a leg, means that if you wear a trouser, you can't hide your problem. Means that when you just wear the trouser, people will never come to know about your thin leg. Understood? But I got the problem on my face. I cannot cover up my face, okay, like Jerry says. He was just worried. He's worried a lot. Understood? So, he says that when you wear a trouser, you can hide your problem. At the same time, I cannot do so. Why? Because my problem is on my face. So, I cannot do anything. And people every time stare at me like the boy says. Okay, Jerry. So, the old man again started giving an advice to him. He just says like this. People used to do like that every time they need something to talk. Okay, so whenever they get a topic, they used to talk. Okay, 1 day, 2 days or 3 days. It will just go a few days. After that, they will get a new topic. Then they forget completely about the old one. That is the fact. Okay, this is the real fact. Like who says? The old man says. That's true. No, we also know that in our life. People just get different topics every day and they used to just burn with the discussions and all. After that, the fume with the discussions and all. When they get the new topic, they totally forget about the old topic. Okay. So, that is the fact in human life. That is only going. So, if people are just staring at you, Derry, means that they will just forget the thing. After some time, they will be getting something like the man says. And he says that every time they just looked at my, people used to look at my thin leg, and they used to discuss about my thin leg and all. After some time, they just forget about my thin leg, like the man says. So, eventually the boy replied that, yes, they forget about your leg and they get my topic, that is my face, and they start talking about my face, like the boy says. Understood? So, every time people get different topics to discuss, you don't bother about them, like he says. And you must believe that beauty means it's not from the appearance. Beauty, that we should see the inner beauty of a man or people. Okay, like we should see that inner beauty. Every time, that is our point of view, we just look at the appearance and we decide that whether handsome or beautiful like that. We just decide from the appearance. Actually, it should not happen. Beauty comes from inside, like the man says. And he added that, you know the story of Beauty and the Beast, like he asked the question to Derry. And even Derry replied that, you don't think that nobody told me the story of Beauty and Beast? I know the story of Beauty and the Beast. I think you, my students, you also might have heard about the story Beauty and the Beast. What it is? Yes, here Derry gives that reply. In that story, a beautiful girl loved a monster, understood? And when the girl kissed the monster turned into a handsome prince and they got married. That is the story of Beauty and Beast. So, Derry said that, I know the story, this is the story, but those things happen only in stories, not in real life. What is that? A girl, beautiful girl, loved a monster, and when the girl kissed with the monster turned into a handsome prince. Only such things happen in stories or movies, okay, not in real life. So, nothing will happen in my life, okay. So, nobody will love me or nobody will come to me and I will be like this, like that monster. I will never change because that is a story and this is reality, like the boy says. Clear? Mr. Lamb, in that way, no, you won't, Derry. And no one else kissed me ever, only my mother. And she kisses me on the other side of my face and I don't like my mother to kiss me. She does it because she has to. Why should I like that? I don't care if nobody ever kisses me. Mr. Lamb, but do you care if you never kiss them? Derry, what? Mr. Lamb, girls, pretty girls, long hair and large eyes, people you love. Derry, won't let me, not one. Mr. Lamb, who can tell? Derry, I won't ever look different. When I'm as old as you, I look the same. I'll still only have half a face, Mr. Lamb. So you will, but the world won't. The worst got a whole face and the worst there to be looked at. Gary, do you think this is the world, this old garden, Mr. Lamb? When I'm here, not the only one, but the world as much as anywhere. Gary, does your leg hurt you? Mr. Lamb, tin doesn't hurt boy. Gary, when it came off, did it? Mr. Lamb, certainly. Gary, and now, I mean, where the tin stops, at the top? Mr. Lamb, now and then, in wet weather, it doesn't signify. Gary, oh, that's something else they all say. Look at all those people who are in pain and brave and never cry and never complain and don't feel sorry for themselves. Mr. Lamb, I haven't said it. Gary, and think of all those people worse off than you. Think you might have been blinded or born deaf or have to live in a wheelchair or be deaf in your head and dribble. Mr. Lamb, and that's all true and you know it. Gary, it won't make my face change. Do you know, one day a woman went by me in street. I was at a bus stop and she was with another woman and she looked at me and she said, whispered, only I heard her. She said, look at that. That's a terrible thing. That's a face only a mother could love. Mr. Lamb, so you believe everything you hear then? Daddy, it was cruel. Mr. Lamb, maybe not meant as such, just something said between them. Daddy, oh, only I heard it. I heard. Mr. Lamb, and is that the only thing you ever heard anyone say in your life? Daddy, oh no, I have heard a lot of things. Mr. Lamb, so now you keep your ears shut. Daddy, you are peculiar, so say peculiar things. You ask questions I don't understand. Mr. Lamb, I like to talk, have company. You don't have to answer questions. You don't have to stop here at all. The gates open. Daddy, yes, but... Mr. Lamb, I have a hive of bees behind those trees over there. Some hear bees and they say bees buzz. But when you listen to bees for a long while, they hum. And hum means sing. I hear them singing, my bees. Daddy, but I like it here. I came in because I liked it when I looked over the wall. Mr. Lamb, if you'd seen me, you would not have come in. Daddy, no. Mr. Lamb, no. Daddy, it had been... trespassing. Mr. Lamb, oh, that's not why. Daddy, I don't like being near people. When they share, when I see them being afraid of me. So, like Beauty and the Beast, I won't change, like the boy says. Okay, Daddy. So, Mr. Lamb agreed. Yes, of course, it won't happen in your life that we know that only story and this is reality. I also know that. You will not change like that. And that time, Daddy says that even my mother only kiss me, okay, because other people, they don't like to kiss me. So my mother used to kiss me, that too she has to do. She is my mother, that's why no other way, that's why she kisses me, that too on the other side of my face, not where is the bird, she never kisses there, and instead on the other side of my face she kisses me. And whenever my mother kisses me, I don't like it, okay, because she doesn't have any other option, that's why she used to do, and I hate it. I don't want that kiss like that way I feel, and only my mother used to kiss me like she says, okay. So Mr. Lamb says that he now is just see his positivity, okay. Mr. Lamb says that, okay, people, they don't want to kiss you, at the same time you can try to kiss them. No, you only you have the problem, that's why people are not kissing you. At the same time, the other people, they don't have any problem at all, and you can try to kiss them like the man says, okay. So the boy say ask that, who will let me to kiss, like. So the man says that, beautiful girls, if you love someone, you can just kiss someone, like he says, okay. Means your lover, you can if you want, like. So the boy asked that, who will love me? Okay, when they just see my face, who will love me? Who will let me kiss? Okay, it will never happen in my life, like he says. Okay, I'll be like this. And like the story, Beauty and the Beast, I will never change. So I'll not get anyone to kiss and nobody likes me, like the boy says. Clear. And after that, the boy just explained or narrates an incident happened in his life. The boy says that one day I was just walking near the bus stop, okay, and then two women, they were just waiting there for a bus, okay. When I passed there, both women, they just started talking each other. They says that, just look at that face, so horrible, okay. okay? Only mother can love that face, okay? It's ugly face, like that way the both women were talking in the bus stop about me. I heard it, like the boy says. So, immediately, Mr. Lamb says that you don't believe whatever you hear, okay? That's a very good advice, okay? You can hear a lot of things from people. Whatever you hear, you don't believe everything, understood? It's not necessary. People are like that. If they want, they can just tell, okay, whatever you hear, you just take everything to your heart, means you cannot live in this world. That is the advice given by Mr. Lamb. A beautiful advice, am I right? So people can talk. You, if you take all the things to your mind and if you want to live according to their opinion, it will never happen, okay, in this world. So you don't believe whatever you hear, like he just advises. And one more thing he added, Mr. Lamb says that you don't think that the both ladies, they just both were talking about something else. You just think like that. They were not talking about you. They were discussing something else. And that time you just cross there. Okay, like that way if you think, the problem will be solved, like the man advised. Understood? When you just think that they were talking about you, then only the problem creates. At the same time, you leave the thing, okay, and you just conclude your mind that they were talking something else, that time you just pass through that way. Like that way, if you think, the problem is solved, like the man advised. So, Jerry immediately corrected that. No, no, I will never think like that. I heard it, they were talking about me only, like he says. So, again, the old man, Mr. Lamb, gives another advice to Jerry. I told you in the beginning, Jerry is a defiant boy. He's a rebel. He never accepts whoever says something. He never accepts this. He has his own views. He has his own thoughts and talks. Understood? So, now this man is going to give him some positive thoughts. Okay. Whether he will be succeed or not, let's see. Understood? So, the man again advises Jerry that, see, okay, if it happens like that, no problem. You do one thing, shut your ears. If you don't like to hear something, shut your ears. Don't listen to people. If you like something, you can just open your ears and listen to them. If you don't like something, shut your ears and should not listen to those words. And this advice is applicable for we people also. Am I right? Why? Because really, we just go and sit somewhere and people used to talk about something and which we don't like also. We just forced to listen to those words. And after some time, we start thinking about it and will be worried. Okay, why too? It's just, if you don't like the things, shut your ears and should not listen. Okay, that is a simple solution to overcome your worries, like the man advised to Derry. Clear? So, when Derry heard this advice from Mr. Lamb, he says that, Derry says that, you are so peculiar, so special type of person, and you speak peculiar things, okay, which I don't understand. You ask something, you just give some reply and all. What you say, I don't really understand. Because, Mr. Lamb, you are a peculiar person, a special type of person, and you are speak or your words also peculiar to me. I don't understand, like Derry says, okay. So that time, Mr. Lamb says that, okay, if you want, I like to talk to people. Whoever comes to my garden, I just talk. I don't wait for their reply. And I don't have the mind that they must give me reply. Okay, I don't think like that. I like to talk, so I do so. Understood? At the same time, it is not necessary to give reply to my question. And Derry, if you don't like my presence here, this is my garden and gate is open, please go out, like the man asked, old man asked. So, Derry says that, I like this place. When I just look over the wall, I want to be here, like that I wish. That's why I have come here, because I want to spend some time here. That's why only I have come here, like the boy says. Clear? And that time, the man says that, see, Derry, I have a beehive in my garden. Some people just go near the beehive and they say that bees buzz. Okay, means in their view or according to them, bees buzz. But I always say that bees humming sound, that means bees sing. Means I consider their buzz as songs, okay, or they just sing for me like that, I consider that is my point of view. Means that people are different, okay, they just think different, they work different, and then they just behave different. So that differences, individual differences are there, and that too our thought or our behavior make as understood. Means that how we just think, how we just act, that it is up to us only, okay, nobody compel us, okay. At the same time, I just think that these bees are singing for me, but people, they say bees, bruises. So that difference we both have. I like to talk, I ask question, it's not necessary that you must give me answer, okay. So anyhow, you have come here to enjoy, means you can, no problem. At the same time, Derry, you just thought that nobody is here, empty garden, that's why only you have come here. And if you come to know that I have here, like, you would never come to my garden, am I right? Like Mr. Lamb asked. So Derry agrees, he says that, yes, I thought this is empty garden, that's why only I have come. If I come to know that you are here, sure, I would not come here, because I don't like to be with people. Whenever people just look at my face, they are afraid of me. That's why I don't want to spend time with any people. I like to be alone, like the boy replies. Okay, so see here, he's really disappointed about his life. We come to know that total disappointment we can see in his life, okay, because that accident happens and he's not he is not able to show his face outside like that. When he come to know that this will be permanent, and he is totally disappointed, and he starts hating his life. And here only he got a wonderful company, that is Mr. Lam. He sees the things positive, okay, he takes life in a light way, and here he tries to give positive thoughts or positive spirit to Derry's life. That only we can see through this lesson. And finally, we will come to know that whether Mr. Lam has succeeded in it or not, okay, whether he is able to change Derry's life or not. Okay, let's see. Mr. Lam, you could lock yourself up in a room and never leave it. There was a man who did that. He was afraid, you see, of everything. Everything in this world, a bus might run him over, or a man might breathe deadly germs onto him, or a donkey might kill him to death, or lightning might strike him down, or he might love a girl and the girl would leave him, and he might slip on a banana skin and fall, and people who saw him would laugh their heads off. So he went into this room, his room, and locked the door and got into his bed and stayed there. Derry, forever? Mr. Lam, for a while. Derry, then what? Mr. Lam, a picture fell off the wall onto his head and killed him. Derry laughs a lot. Mr. Lam, you see, Derry, but you still say peculiar things. Mr. Lam, peculiar to some. Derry, what do you do all day? Mr. Lam, sit in the sun, read books. You thought it was an empty house, but inside it's full, books and other things full. Derry, but there aren't any curtains at the windows. Mr. Lam, I'm not fond of curtains, shutting things out, shutting things in. I like the light and the darkness and the windows open to hear the wind. Derry, yes, I like that. When it's raining, I like to hear it on the roof. Mr. Lam, so you are not lost, are you? Not altogether. You do hear things, you listen. Derry, they talk about me downstairs when I'm not there. What will he ever do? What's going to happen to him when we have gone? However, will he get on in this world looking like that, with that on his face? That's what they say. So Derry says that people are afraid of me, so I don't want to sit with any people. I want to be alone, like he says. So immediately Mr. Lam says that, okay, if you don't like people, you just go and shut your room and stay there inside always, okay, should not come outside. Because this is a crowded world, when you come, you must meet people. If you don't like meeting them, you just go and shut the door and sit inside, like he says. And he just said him a story also, who Mr. Lam, to Derry. He said that once upon a time there was a man, he just had a lot of fear in his life, okay. His fear is that when he just walk through the road, sometimes the bus run over him and kill him, or sometimes when he just walk through, he just might step on a banana peel and fell down, or sometimes lightning, it just come and kill him, might come and kill him, like that. He's always fear of his death. So he doesn't want to go outside. Why? Because outside he can see everywhere the dangerous things and it would kill him. That was his thought, okay? So what the man did, you know, Derry, he just went to his room and locked the room and just started staying inside because he doesn't want to come out. Why? He is fear, just he has a great fear of his death. So he locked the room, like the man says. So Derry asked that he just stays there always for long time, like Derry asked. So the man said that not for long, for a while only, like the man says. So Derry asked that what happened to him. Derry was very curious to know about the man's story. So he asked that what happened to him. Lamb explains that a picture was, see, he just locked up himself in his room and he stays inside and he thought that he's safe because nothing will happen in that room, like that way he just thought. But what do you know? Just near over his head on the wall, a picture was just hung, okay? And that picture fell off to his head and killed him, like the man said, okay? So now our Derry started laughing, okay? He just laughed a lot for the first time, understood? And then the man added that whatever comes to our life is God's decision, it will come, okay? You cannot stop it or prevent it, understood? You must just go forth. That only, okay, we can do. At the same time, our life, it's already our fate and life, it's decided by the God. So, whatever He has decided, that will come to our life. We cannot stop or prevent. That only happened to that man. He thought that in his room he's safe, okay, but there also that danger was there and that picture killed him, like the man said. And now, Derry says that, now also you say peculiar things like, okay. So, the man, old man, Mr. Lamb says that peculiar to someone, okay. You people think that I am just saying peculiar things and all, but I don't think so. The normal facts I am giving you, like the man says, okay. So, Derry just wants to listen to his words, like that way the situation goes now. Before he just started opposing everything, now he just enjoys his words and all, okay. He started listening to his words. And after that, Derry asked him, requested that, you just stay here alone, nobody is here. And how do you spend your time, like Derry asked. So the man immediately replies that, I like to sit in the sun. I just come out of my house and sit in the sun. When I go to my home, I have a lot of books inside my house. I read, I like reading. Understood? And Derry, you only thought that house is empty, but you know the house is full with books and other things, okay? And I like reading, so whenever I'll be inside the house, I used to read. At the same time, whenever I want to come and enjoy the garden, I come and sit here, enjoy the sun and the bee song and all, okay? That's my life and I pass my time like this, he explains, okay? And that time only, Derry observed that, in that beautiful small house is there in the garden. I told you already, that house, he doesn't use any curtains, okay? We people all know that when we build our house, we just used to fix the curtains, okay? But Mr. Lamb's house, there were no curtains, that Derry noticed. So Derry asked that, why are you not using curtains in your home, like? So, Mr. Lamb, here also you will be getting a beautiful message, okay? He says that, I don't like curtains, okay? Why people are using curtains, you know, Derry? Because they want to lock something inside or they don't want something to come in, okay? We people know that what's the function of the curtain? When we just hang the curtains, we never allow something to come in or we never allow something to go outside. Means that our privacy we must keep, okay? What all things happen inside the house, it should not go out. At the same time, the unnecessary things from the outside, okay, that also should not come in. That is the purpose of keeping a curtain. And here, I don't like curtain, Mr. Derry. Why, you know? Because I want to enjoy the outside view, I want to enjoy the wind, and whatever wants to come to my house can come, and whatever wants to go out of my house also can. I don't want to prevent anything by using this curtain, so I never use curtains in my home, like he explained to Derry. Okay, you just see that, no, that was a different thought only. We people used to do like that, we just shut everything in our home, okay, that negativity is positive, whatever it is. We need every time that privacy. We don't enjoy the outside things, okay? So, close everything and stay somewhere, okay? That's the practice. But here, he's a positive type of person, okay? Very optimist, who Mr. Lamb, and he says that, just I allow something to go out and something to come in. I don't want to use any curtain to prevent those things, like he says. Clear? So Mr. Lamb says that I like wind, I just enjoy wind and rain, like he says. Okay. When Derry heard this, he immediately replied that, yes, I too, I like rain, okay? Even I enjoy the sound of rain or the voice of the rain. When it touches the roof, I just enjoy the song of the rain, like Derry says. So, Mr. Lamb was really happy to hear that, and Mr. Lamb said that, you are not completely lost, okay? Very important line, okay? You underline, you are not completely lost, means that, still, you have that mind, okay? You means totally you are not disappointed. You also enjoy some things in this world. Means that there are some particular things for you also God has given in this world, and you enjoy those things, okay? So you are not totally disappointed or completely lost. It's very happy to know that, because you enjoy rain, okay? At least something is there to enjoy in this world for you also, like Mr. Lamb says, okay? And that time Derry says, see, actually, you know, my house, everybody, they are just really, they worry about me, okay? And many times I heard their words when I was just upstairs, downstairs, people used to talk about me, and even my relatives, okay, mother and others, they used to think about me and worry a lot. And they just, many times I heard their words, they used to say that, how this boy will live like this with the burnt face and all? Who will take care of him after our life, or mother, or whoever they are taking care of him, if they pass away or if something happened to them, and who will take care of this boy, and he will never get a good life, and how his life will be. Every time they worry about my life, okay? That is really a torture for me. Whenever I just hear these type of words, it just really painful, like he says, okay? Mr. Lamb, Lord boy, you have got two arms, two legs and eyes and ears. You have got a tongue and a brain. You will get on the way you want, like all the rest. And if you choose and set your mind to it, you could get on better than all the rest. Derry, how? Mr. Lamb, same way as I do. Derry, do you have any friends? Mr. Lamb, hundreds. Derry, but you live by yourself in that house. It's a big house too. Mr. Lamb, friends everywhere, people come in, everybody knows me, the gate's always open. They come and sit here and in front of the fire in winter, kids come for the apples and pears. And for toffee, I make toffee with honey, anybody comes, so have you. Derry, but I'm not a friend. Mr. Lamb, certainly you are, so far as I'm concerned. What have you done to make me think you are not? Derry, you don't know me, you don't know where I come from or even what my name is. Mr. Lamb, why should that signify? Do I have to write all your particulars down and put them in a filing box before you can be a friend? Derry, I suppose not, no. Mr. Lamb, you could tell me your name if you choose, and not if you didn't. Derry, only it's Derek, but I hate that. Derry, if I'm your friend, you don't have to be mine. I choose that. Mr. Lamb, certainly. I might never come here again. You might never see me again, and then I couldn't still be a friend. Mr. Lamb, why not? Derry, how could I? You pass people in the street and you might even speak to them, but you never see them again. It doesn't mean they are friends. Mr. Lamb, doesn't mean they are enemies either, does it? Derry, they are just nothing people, that's all. Mr. Lamb, people are never just nothing, never. Derry, there are some people I hate. Mr. Lamb, that I do you more harm than any bottle of acid. Acid only burns your face. So the boy says that his relatives or mother, parents and all, they worry about him, and who would look after him after their death, like that they worry. Okay, like that he shared the view. So immediately Mr. Lamb says that, Lord, God, boy, God, okay, God is there to take care of everyone. Why should we worry about that? He only has created us, so he just take care of us. You don't worry about it, okay? Like the man advises, okay? And Mr. Lamb says that you have two eyes, two arms, two legs, and even a tongue and a good brain to think also, okay? And you can make it all the things, whatever you want in your life, like others, so, okay? Only you burn half side of your face, that only happen to you. Other, all the rest of the things, all are free, and you have that, okay? It's working, and you have to use it to your own way, whatever you want, you are interested in, you have to just work it on, and then you will achieve everything in your life. You don't worry about the things, okay? It doesn't matter, like he says. Means that here also a very good advice or message you people get, okay? We just always we worry over the things which we do not have, understood? But when we just think like this, we have other all the things, but we never use it or we never bother about it. Only what we do not have, we worry over the things. Am I right? Here, Derry also do the same thing. He just got burnt face and he always worries over his burnt face. At the same time here, Mr. Lamb says that you have two arms, two legs, good brain and tongue to talk, okay? And you have your own dreams in your life. So if you want to achieve your goal in your life, you have to set it and work, okay? Sure, you will be achieving everything in your life, boy. Do not worry, like the man says. That time, Derry asked him that, do you have any friends? Like he asked. So Mr. Lamb says that, 100 of friends I have, okay? A lot of friends I have. So Derry asked that, you leave here alone, that too inside the garden and all, then how can you make friends with others, like he asked. So the old man, Mr. Lamb, says that a lot of people used to come inside this garden, okay, and some people, they just come winter season, they just come and sit near the fire. Sometimes kids used to come and they take the crab apples and I just make toffees for them with honey, and kids, they just like it. They come to take toffees from me. Like that, a lot of people come to my garden and they all are my friends. And even Derry, you also, means boy, you also come to my garden. You are also my friend, like Mr. Lamb says. Okay, that time Derry says that, no, I'm not your friend, like he says. Okay, here also he showed that defiant character. Okay, so Mr. Lamb says that, okay, no problem. You don't want to be my friend, means leave it. But I just consider, okay, as far as I'm concerned, you are my friend, okay, that you cannot stop, okay, I think you are my friend, means only for my side, from my side. If you don't want to make me as your friend, leave it, no problem, okay, but you cannot prevent me, okay, you are my friend, like he said, okay. So Derry asked that, a lot of people used to come here and even you just talk to everyone, you don't know even their name and my name also you don't know. You never asked that. Then also, I'll be your friend, like he asked. So the old man asked that, he also asked that another question only. Is it necessary to take all the particulars of a person to make him a friend, like he asked? That's a very good question, no. If you just like someone's character, you don't want to ask anything about their whereabouts. Am I right? Where they study, what is their name, what are the things they have and all. We don't want to know about their whereabouts. At the same time, if you like someone, we'll become friends. Am I right? That only the old man says. So, boy, is it necessary to write your name, address and everything in a file and I have to keep it? Then only I'll become your friends. It is necessary. Is it necessary? Like he asked. So, then he asked that, see, still you don't know my name, okay? And you'd ask me also, like the boy says. So, the old man replied, if you want to tell your name, if you are so particular about that, you can tell your name, like he asked. So Derry says that, my name is Derry. Actually, my name is Derek, but I hate that name and I like Derry. Everyone, I mean, people who love me, they call me Derry, okay, like he says. Okay, and now the man understood his name and all. So now Derry says that, see, many people used to come here to your garden and they just, whatever they want, they take it from you. And after that, they go back and they will never be back again. Then also you say that they are your friends. And the same thing is going to happen with me. I have come here only today. I will never come back again. I'm not going to come back at all. Okay. Then also, I'll be your friend, like he asked. So the man says that, as far as I'm concerned, sure, you are my friend. Because you didn't do anything harm to me. So you are not my enemy. If you are not my enemy, sure, you are my friend, like he says. Okay.